Welcome to Genius Connect. Please subscribe and share.
Sharing is caring, right? But when it's come to chocolate, no one likes to share it, isn't it? Whenever you share something or divide something, there is lot of mathematics behind it. Hello and welcome friends, I am Darshana Tak and I am from Genius School. Today I will teach you fractions, right? Let's start the session with you and some of your friends. You and your two friends went to Ria's house. All you have is one big chocolate that you have to divide among your friends, including Ria, but no cheating. Now, how will you do that? Nice, you have divided it into four equal parts, right? Or we can say that each one of you have one part of big chocolate. Right? Or we can say that you have 1/4 part of the chocolate. Numbers in these forms are called as fractions. Right? Now we will take one simple example and it is A divided by B. Right? Now what is fraction? A fraction simply tells us about how many parts of a whole we have. You can recognize a fraction by the slash that is written between two numbers. Now, I said before, A divided by B is fraction, where A is top number and B is bottom number. And A is called as numerator and B is called as denominator. Now, what is numerator? Numerator is the number of equal parts that is taken out or that is left out. Now, what is denominator? Denominator is numbers of equal parts in which the whole is divided into. Like as I said before, A divided by B is fraction, where B cannot be 0. But why B cannot be 0? Because we can't divide anything by 0. Still confused? By the way, what is denominator? Denominator itself says that denominator is the number in which the whole is divided into. We cannot divide anything by 0. We cannot give anything to anyone. Right? So B cannot be 0. It is the golden rule of mathematics. Now suppose your uncle asks you how much chocolate you had. But you can't say that I had one big chocolate because you have divided it into four equal parts. Right? But as you all know, what is fraction? You can proudly say that I had 1/4 part of the chocolate. Now can you tell me that how much part of the chocolate did all your remaining friends have? 3 parts of the chocolate were remaining out of 4 parts. So they had 3/4 part of the chocolate. Now we will move to various types of fractions. If you will eat 9 chocolates out of 10 chocolates. Imagine if you had 100, 1000 or 10,000 chocolates. So here the types of fractions which have the denominator as 10 or higher powers of 10 are known as decimal fractions. Till now, whatever examples we saw, 1/4, 2/3, 1/2, 3/4 are the examples of proper fractions. Proper fractions means the fractions which have the numerator is smaller than the denominator, right? These examples were the examples of proper fractions. Then what is the improper fractions? With improper fractions, nothing is improper. It is just called as improper fractions, like 100 by 9, 25 by 4, 20 by 10, right? Don't confuse yourself between proper fractions and improper fractions. Whenever you perform a normal division on proper fraction, the answer will be always less than 1. For example, 1 divided by 4 and the answer will be 0.25. Whenever we perform a normal division on an improper fraction and the answer will be always more than 1. For example, 5 divided by 4 and answer will be 1.25. Whenever our answer will be less than 1, then it is proper fraction, and whenever our answer will be more than 1, then it will be improper fractions. Are we good till here? Fine. Let's move on. Improper fractions can be further written in different manner also. We just saw an example of improper fraction and that is 5 divided by 4. Imagine if you guys have 5 chocolates and 4 people only. Now how will you divide it among your friends? You can take first of all 1 chocolate each. Still, you left with 1 chocolate, right? As same question we have started our session, right? And you all know you will get 1/4 part of the chocolate among you, right? So all you have is 1 big chocolate and 1/4 part of other chocolate, right? So total you have 1/4 part of the chocolate, right? This type of fraction are known as mixed fractions. You can also obtain mixed fraction by performing a normal division. Let's see how we can do that. For example, 5 divided by 4. A mixed fraction is written as quotient remainder divided by divisor, and our answer will be 1/1/4, right? Here 1 is quotient, another 1 is remainder, and 4 is a divisor, right? Mixed fractions are nothing, it is just another way of writing improper fractions. In this process, we have learned how to convert improper fractions into mixed fractions. Before leaving, I would like to ask the questions about the fractions, right? You can see the images here. Can you tell me these images are the proper fractions or not? I will be excited to know your answers, and you can put them into below comment section. Till then, keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.
I hope you all would have enjoyed this video. Subscribe to Genius Connect and put on the notification to receive more such videos. Like and share this video too. Thanks for watching.